Java, a programming language that is used almost everywhere. Some of us like it while others try to avoid it as much as they can. Let's learn Java in 5 minutes. But before that, why Java is so popular? Why was it developed in the first place? To find the answer to these questions, let's go back in time and explore how Java was born. In the early 1990s, there was a growing need for a platform-independent language to write software that could run on various electronic devices. While C and C++ were the popular choices at the time, they were considered platform-dependent. So, there was a need for a platform-independent language. Recognizing this need, in 1991, James Gosling and his team began developing a new programming language initially named Oak. But later, it got a name change in 1995 to something you are probably very familiar with, Java. Fast forward to today, Java stands as one of the most widely used programming languages, and it is used everywhere, from Android development, web application, gaming, embedded systems, and more. Its syntax is similar to C and C++ language, but with automatic memory management that makes it more secure. The mantra of Java is, write once, run everywhere, highlighting its platform independence. Unlike C or C++, where source code is compiled into machine language, Java compiles source code into bytecode, which can run on any platform using the Java virtual machine. This unique feature makes Java both a compiled and interpreted programming language. To embark on your Java journey, the first step is to create a class using the class keyword. It's important to note that your file name should match your class name. Oh, and remember, Java is an object-oriented programming language. So, you should be familiar with some basic object-oriented programming concepts.
You know, I don't have any idea what that means.
Don't worry, I've got your back. A single line of code is a statement. When you group multiple statements together, you create a function. Then, when you group multiple functions and statements, you create a class. Think of a class as a template that describes how to create something. Let's take a real-world example, a car. Imagine a class as the basic blueprint of a car, where you can define its characteristics like color and the number of wheels. These are called attributes. To create a car with these attributes, you use a constructor, which has the same name as the class itself. A car can perform actions like starting, stopping, honking, and more. To define these actions for a car, you create functions within the car class. These functions are called as methods. Methods and functions essentially mean the same thing, but when we use functions within a class, we call them methods. Now, up until now, we have only created a blueprint for a car, not an actual car. To create an actual car based on this blueprint, you use the class name, followed by an object name of your choice, and then the new keyword, and finally the class name again with attributes in brackets. This way, you have created your first car using the car class. You can create as many cars as you want and access the methods of each car separately. These objects are also called as an instance of a class. Let's get back to creating our basic program. You start by defining a class with the same file name, and then there is something important to remember: public static void main string args. This is where we create our main function. Void is the return type of our function, and the actual code goes inside curly braces. To print something, you can use system.out.println with whatever you want to print inside the parentheses. Now, you might wonder about public and static. Public is an access specifier which controls who can access this main function. There are four main access specifiers in Java: public, private, protected, and default. Public means anyone can access it. Private means only the same class can access it. Protected means it can be accessed within the same class and its subclasses. And when you don't specify any access specifier, it defaults to package private, which means it can be accessed by anyone within the same package, but not from outside. Now, let's talk about static. Static is used to create variables and methods that belong to a class rather than an instance of a class. For example, in our car class, you can access variables and methods after creating an object. But if you declare a static variable, like number of cars, and increment it in the constructor, you can access the number of cars without creating an object. This is different from non-static variables and methods. Since static variables and methods belong to the class itself, objects created from that class share the same value for static variables. If you change the value of a static variable in one object, it reflects in all other objects too. Now, our main function is the entry point of our program. So, it needs to be accessible without creating an object. That's why we use the static keyword. And then, string args is used to pass command line arguments to our Java program. Once you are done with your coding, you can use Java C followed by your file name to compile your Java code into bytecode. Then use Java followed by your file name to run your Java program. This was Java in 5 minutes, and here's your certificate. Now go ahead and make your own Minecraft game.